Yo, what is up, everybody? If you're tuning into the video, I just want to say thank you. But this one is going to be all about the Karhu Ikoni Trail. First off, I just got to say thank you to Lee from Karhu. He hooked me up with these, and I love how this shoe looks. I love how it fits, and I'm super excited to take it out for this first run. Today, I'm going to take it for a 14-mile run out on the trails, and we're really going to see how this thing does out there. So make sure y'all stay tuned, and thanks again for watching. Let's get it. So right off the bat, I'm really liking how these fit. The upper is nice and secure, not too tight, and the same with the toe box. I have enough space to splay out my toes, but it's not too narrow or too wide. Oh, I can't wait to hit the trails. This skyline, like, is honestly, just looks crazy. Like, look at that. All right, so I'm here at Taos Camp at Lake Georgetown in Georgetown, Texas. I got my Karhu Ikoni trails on. And we're ready to rip this trail. So let's go ahead and get this run started. All right, here we go. All right, guys, we just hit mile one. Feeling pretty good so far. Just enjoying the run. Yeah. Mile three, I'm grinding this little uphill. Just hit mile three, sun's going down. Let there be light. All right, this is where the trail leads, right into a tree. It's pretty technical on this trail. That's why I started at Tejas Camp, because it's primarily flat for the first 4 miles, but then you're getting this rocky, rooty area, which is a blast. Look at that moon. It's shining out today. Just hit mile seven. These have felt great so far, and damn, just look at them, man. They just look so fresh. They really do, man. I love how they look. But yeah, mile seven, feeling good. Definitely had to start watching my step. If it was daytime, I'd be able to move a little bit quicker. But with all these rocks and roots and this dim headlight, I can barely see. But yeah, 7 more miles to go. Logging miles. Let's get it. I hear something over here. Oh, it's armadillo. Hey, buddy, come back. Okay, guys, we are on mile 10.1. My average pace is about 11 minutes per mile. Karhu Ikoni Trails, feeling great. Mile 11. Mile 12, basically walked that whole mile. Yeah. Mile 13. Ooh. Okay, guys, 14 miles, pretty slow average pace, somewhere like right under a 12-minute pace. That puts me at 100 miles over the past 7 days, doing high mileage training for my next ultra. But I'm gonna go ahead, get some water in, head back to the house, get some calories in, and then we'll go over the first impression of the Karhu Ikoni Trail.
Water is the best thing on earth, man.
All right, guys, so we got back, got some electrolytes in, some water and some food, and now let's go ahead and talk about how I felt about the Karhu Ikoni Trail. So first off, compared to my typical trail running shoe, this felt pretty lightweight. There was never a point on the trail when I was like, oh, this thing is a brick, it's heavy. So yeah, I'll give it that, the weight is on point. So at the start of the run, I felt like this shoe felt pretty firm. Once I got to like mile two, my foot kind of adapted to the shoe and broke it in a little bit. It felt like a mid-level cushioning shoe, so it didn't feel like it was like too hard or too firm or anything like that. So it was solid. The cushioning was solid. It's not a Hoka Speed Goat 4. So I feel like the fit of the shoe would be pretty good for someone that has a wider heel and a wider foot in general. I feel like, yeah, it just was a little bit loose. A little bit loose in there, but not to a point where it was like, you know, out of hand. It just, I can tell that if you have a wider heel, you're probably going to like the feel of the shoe. And as well as the toe box, it's not a shallow toe box. It actually has a good amount of space. Honestly, I prefer having a little bit more room in that toe box. Your feet are gonna swell up, you know, when you're running long distance. And also, it's just important that you have enough space for your toes to splay out so they're not really like being restricted. And I definitely enjoyed that. The upper felt solid. I felt secure in the shoe. There's no issues with that whatsoever. So on bottom of the shoe, they have some pretty aggressive lugs. Yeah, all these lugs, you're gonna have great grip out there on the trail, and I really enjoyed that. And then also in this forefoot, you can see they have these flex grooves horizontally and vertically. So the shoe is a little bit more flexible. It's gonna move with your foot a little bit better. But yeah, overall, for my first impression, that's really all I got. I love the looks of the shoe. Felt lightweight, felt a little bit wider in that toe box and in the heel. Mid-level cushioning. I enjoyed the grip. I enjoyed it on the run. And I'm just gonna leave it at that. If you guys have gotten to try the shoe, make sure you comment down below. Let me know what you think. So a more in-depth review of the Karhu Ikoni Trail will be coming out once I've done at least 50 miles out on the trails in this shoe. And I'm gonna be reviewing many other shoes. So make sure you subscribe so you can check those out. Big shout out to Lee at Karhu. Make sure you guys give him a follow right here. He is the one that got these in my hands. So I really appreciate it, bro. Can't wait to keep running in these. If y'all enjoyed this video, I appreciate y'all watching and I'm glad you enjoyed it. Enjoy the rest of your day.